had enough on this. Let me get a car, escape the madness. Music is my passion, but did you know that entertainers like myself help to bring foreign exchange into Barbados? Foreign exchange contributes to the foreign reserve, which helps us to maintain the peg. So whether you're an entertainer or not, you need to stay tuned to this episode to find out why we need to keep earning foreign exchange.
CBB 101, economics about you and me. CBB 101, economics about you and me.
Good day and welcome to CBB 101, a program in which we explain the why, how and what we central bankers do in the context of our recently passed act. I'm Lovelyne Brewster and joining me is Governor Cleviston Haynes. Welcome again, Governor.
Thank you, Lovelyne.
Governor, this week we want to focus a little bit more on this whole issue of the importance of earning foreign exchange. Perhaps you can just remind us why it is critical to maintaining the peg.
The earning of foreign exchange is very critical. As you would appreciate, what we want to be able to do over time is to build our buffer of reserves. The cost of goods are increasing, and therefore you need to be able to have more reserves to buffer those imports that we have. And we do so through tourism, we do so our international business, we can do so through agriculture. Traditionally, sugar was our main export crop. And we also do that through manufacturing and through the services that our professionals are able to provide overseas. So there are a number of ways in which we earn foreign exchange, and to the extent that we are able to earn foreign exchange, it also means that perhaps the less we will have to borrow in order to buffer the foreign exchange reserves.
And elaborate a little bit for us on this whole issue of the importance of competitiveness to the earning of the foreign exchange.
Well, competitiveness is key because you're operating in a world in which all countries are competing, and you want to be able to sell the goods and services which you have. And competitiveness does not just mean price competitiveness, but it's really the quality of the services that we provide, because remember, we are a services-based economy, tourism being the key service, international business services, and therefore it's the quality of the service, the reliability of the service, in much the same way as you would buy a refrigerator that you believe has a good reputation for reliability. Likewise, you're going to buy services that you believe reach the standard that you want for your whatever your business or activity is. So we want, therefore, when our visitors come, for example, to be able to provide them with the type of service that they will say, that is a location that I want to visit again, and one that they want to recommend to their friends and family to visit. And whatever service we provide, we want to make sure that it's of very high quality. And so therefore, when we speak of competitiveness, it's not just price, although price can be very important, but it's also the quality of service that we provide.
And Governor, as it relates to the issue of maintaining this buffer, which we have set as a reasonable amount is 12 weeks, how do we maintain as an institution that healthy buffer? What are the levers available to us?
So there are a couple of things. On the one hand, we talked about earning foreign exchange. Occasionally, we will also borrow from abroad, and the borrowing from abroad can serve two purposes in a sense. One is to buffer the reserves, but it also helps with financing of government, because sometimes government will need to borrow. In fact, generally government needs to borrow, and it has to make a decision as to whether to borrow domestically or to borrow from abroad, and therefore those borrowings also help from time to time to build the reserves. But you don't want your reserve buildup to be based solely on borrowing. You also need to make sure that some of it is earning, some of it is investments, where the private sector is making investments into the Barbados economy. Obviously they're doing it in order to earn return, but those investments also bring foreign exchange into the economy, and some of that foreign exchange is filtered to the bank to enable it to build these reserves.
Governor, I want us to just zoom in on the relevant clause in the Act that stipulates how we are to respond if we realize that we're losing foreign reserves.
Right, so if we're losing foreign reserves and we're losing it at a rate that might cause us to be concerned about whether or not we're going to be able to maintain that peg of which we spoke the last time, then we have an obligation to advise the minister what we are seeing, what's the nature of the problem, and how do we suggest that we address it. And the addressing of it could take many forms. It could work as a combination. So sometimes it means that we may have to borrow a little, but also it might mean that we have to adjust economic policy. And by economic policy, more often than not, that is fiscal policy. So you say to government, you need to reduce the size of the fiscal imbalance that you have in order to reduce the amount of money that is being put into the system, which eventually could lead to a drain on the foreign exchange. So it's a combination of things that we do. We have to be able to provide the advice based on the context in which we're operating at that point in time.
Okay, we're going to have a specific program to look at borrowing. Well, this whole issue of investments, how do we go about attracting investments to Barbados?
We are a tourism-based economy, and what you tend to see is that persons who are in that area are often looking for new markets. So therefore, we are collaborating with potential investors, selling them on what Barbados has to offer. And if we get the right mix, we're able to bring them here. It might mean bringing a new hotel property, but it may also mean bringing some sort of service that supports the tourism industry. There's a lot of construction activity. If you recall, in the early 2000s, there was a lot of investment on the West Coast, where the Westmorelands and so on were built. All of that is foreign investment, and that foreign investment does two things. It brings in initially foreign exchange. It enables a pickup in construction activity, but it also creates jobs in the long term, for which persons are able to benefit. And at the end of the day, what do we want to see is growth and jobs for those who live in Barbados.
And of course, just to reiterate that these foreign investments are critical to maintain that. Very important.
Yes, the foreign investments are critical, and it has to be alongside of the earnings. And as I said, judicious borrowing from time to time. That is how you maintain your reserves. And when you maintain your reserves like that, then you're able to support the peg, because people have confidence that you always have enough reserves to be able to meet payments that are going to become due in the near future.
And how does John Bung again come into this whole issue of earning foreign reserves
As I said to you last time, one of the critical ways is to do your part in terms of your own economic activity. The ordinary citizen, you have to try and put your best foot forward at all times to be as productive a citizen as possible. That is what will help to enhance the overall competitiveness. So if you, say, are providing a service, it's the quality of that service that you provide to the business or to the visitors. And that is what I think helps at the individual level for us to be able to be more competitive. I think at the macro level, it's a little bit wider than that, but at the individual level, I think productivity is very critical.
Productivity is key.
Yes.
Thank you very much, Governor. That's a good place to wrap. Before we do so, let's leave you with our key takeaways.
Barbados' foreign reserves are built up by earning, borrowing, and private sector investment. We must remain competitive in price and quality of services to help maintain the peg. And each citizen has a role to play in improving the island's competitiveness.
I think if you think of borrowing, think of your own circumstance, and you wanted to get a mortgage in order to build your home, and you took out a 25-year loan, and you carry that loan for the next 25 years. And I'm sure you would not say that that was a bad thing, because without that mortgage, you would not have been able to get the home that you have. And the country, in a sense, is in a similar circumstance. It will need to borrow from time to time. The question really is, how much does it borrow, and is it borrowing more than it can finance?
And thank you very much for tuning in. Hit the buttons below this episode to like and share, and join us next time when we explain when we have to borrow to maintain the peg. See you then.
CBB 101, economics about you and me. CBB 101, economics about you and me.